voices of unknown origin appearing on radio frequencies were first noticed in Scandinavia by the military in the 30s and were put down at the time to secret Nazi transmitters. But the voices spoke in unknown and mixed tongues, and after the war, no records of secret Nazi transmissions ever came to light. The voices didn't stop after the war, but their rapidity and their transient nature precluded study. That is, until the tape recorder came into common usage in the 50s. A group of radio hams in Chicago studied the strange transmissions, male and female voices speaking in polyglot mode and lyrical tones. But it was not until 1959 that a Russian-born Swedish citizen, radio and TV producer and filmmaker, Friedrich Jakobsen, noticed intrusions on tape and commenced his own systematic study. A disturbing fact soon emerged. The voices zeroed in onto the Swede, addressing him by name, revealing a knowledge of his thoughts and actions, and claiming to be the voices of deceased friends and acquaintances. The news spread rapidly, and soon experimenters and scientists all over the world were attempting to duplicate Jorgensen's work. The effect on parapsychologists was traumatic. Accustomed to investigating the blind forces of the poltergeist and endless and somewhat boring parlor and dice-guessing experiments, they were confronted at once with living voices which answered back. Taken by surprise, the British parapsychologists, without conducting experiments, rejected the objectivity of the voices, explaining them as breakthrough from taxis, police messages, or simply mechanical noises in the tape recorder. But their European counterparts were more cautious, and possibly with greater technical resources, they soon found out that they were indeed confronted with someone voices of unknown origin.
Listening
to us,
watching us. Well, we got the passage for their comments on the page.
time after death. But you didn't take my frequency. But you didn't.